Hello there. Welcome back to the show. My name's Chris, and sitting beside me here is Margaret.
Thanks, Chris.
This week, we'll be watching Sports Rundown, be joining Margaret and Rachel on another episode of Movie Reactions, and be celebrating Groundhog Day.
Not so fast. First, we are going to hear from Princess Duvall with The Week Ahead, and Bill Tilden with the Sports Rundown.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to The Rundown. It's Sunday, February 7th. And we are starting the week before a vacation. So it's always a fun week for us at school. We're also starting our scheduling process for next year. If you can believe it, we're already thinking about what next year is going to look like, which is wild to me. So it's a big week prior to the vacation, but it's also a big week for scheduling. So what does that mean? Monday is February 8th, and it's a full remote day, but we're going to be emailing our 9th, 10th, and 11th graders their course selection cards for next year because we're going to start talking about courses and what to sign up for. Later in the evening on Monday is AP Information Night. We're going to invite students that are interested in taking an AP course next year to participate in a video conference with our teaching staff to talk about what AP involves. Tuesday is February 9th. It's a day one. Cohort A is in the building. Cohort B is at home. Wednesday is the 10th. We have Cohort B coming in that day for their day one. Thursday is the 11th and Friday is the 12th. And then we're out of vacation, so we're gearing up towards February break. And what we've always said is that we want checkpoints along the way to make it through a full year in this hybrid plan. And we've made it to February, we're doing really well. The next checkpoint we always identified was February vacation. And we're gonna make it, which is awesome. But then we always deal with 2 weeks of aftermath from a vacation, whether people traveled, hosted events, things like that. It can tend to lead to COVID transmission. So another checkpoint will be, will we be giving this weekly rundown in 3 more weeks? So time will tell. Have a great vacation, everybody. Course selection time.
Thanks for the update, Mr. Duvall and Mr. Tilden.
First on the roster, let's look at some highlights from our sports teams. Play ball.
Thank you.
Nothing beats watching the game.
I'm with you on that one, Chris.
Next up, Margaret and Rachel will be watching the movie Robots in their newest episode of Movie Reactions. Let's roll the clip.
Today's a really exciting day. We've been hyping this movie up on this show for a while now.
I'm so excited.
And we're finally watching it today.
This movie is from 2004, an elegant year. Drumroll, please. It's Robots.
Robots! It's February, usually we like fifth the month, so we do like a Valentine's Day movie, but we couldn't think of any. We love this movie.
Yeah.
We love this movie, and a Valentine's Day in February is all about love, so we're gonna watch this.
We're starting off strong.
I'm here!
Oh, honey, I'm so sorry. You missed the delivery.
But it's okay. Making the baby's the fun part.
I don't think I got that as a kid. This is so amazing.
We're not even 5 minutes in, this movie's genius!
You just took
got your nose!
Oh my gosh!
Jetpack.
Get body.
He lost his pants.
Is his dad a fridge?
He's
Oh no, he's like an actual dishwasher.
He's a dishwasher.
Get out. What a fun little feature. When you're done with your plate, you can just go.
You wanna do that?
No, not really.
When is, Robin Williamson coming in?
Oh, soon. I think that's like his, he meets him on like the, hamster ball. Oh, okay.
He's like,
so what does he want to be?
He wants to like, be an inventor, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, what? They've already got everything. Did you see that dancing toaster? What more could they need?
I think this is cool. If this was a ride, I would like this ride.
Oh, okay, Universal. I can't believe they got Robin Williams to do this movie.
Oh, it made it such a good movie.
Stupid Words Evil Incorporated. After Hours. That's the bad guy.
Yeah, he's the bad guy. He just looks like a bad guy. They always do that.
They always do that
in like big meetings.
Why would robots buy new upgrades if parts are so much cheaper?
Oh, right. Well, that's easy, because as of today, we are no longer making spare parts.
Do you know what I call robots who can't afford upgrades?
Scrap metal.
Capitalism? Patriarchy. All right?
The Apple company is watching this like,
this is why diet shows exist? This is why clothing is sized down?
It's all your fault, robots!
Shoot, go on, get up!
Oh, ah, get up!
Why are there birds, robots?
I don't... Because the birds are, the birds work for the gun.
Of course, birds work for the bourgeoisie.
The birds work for the bourgeoisie.
We'll be working very, very closely together on this one. Won't that be fun?
Harassment in the workplace. That's a lady.
I love this. Look at her. She is the queen bee.
More than a woman.
She sings a song.
She has a song.
Yes! This slut, though.
Is that her burning all the poor people?
Yeah.
That's morbid.
See, she's making them into, like, fancy things. It's underpaid laborers, probably, as well.
All the workers they can't afford to keep, they just throw in the kiln.
When I get all steamed up, hear me shout.
Just tip me over and pour me out.
You know this probably wasn't scripted either. You know he's probably just in the sound booth, like, just going off.
I want to see the clips of that. That sounds so funny. Look at them dancing like a ball. They got a spotlight and everything.
They're phenomenal.
By the way, the name's Piper. Rhymes with Viper.
harassment in the workplace. She fell.
Crap.
Jennifer.
Oh my god! Yes!
They could not have casted this role better.
They couldn't.
Rodney, you're number one.
You're number one. The toilet.
Yeah.
Kill me. Relax. It's me, your mommy.
Relax. It's me, your mommy.
I'm singing in the oil. I'm singing in the oil.
He's a good dancer.
In the oil.
Again, you can't convince me that this was not Robin Williams' improv.
This gives me like Endgame vibes.
Wow, this is actually Endgame.
That's so funny!
Not Marvel stealing this.
Oh my gosh!
Mr. and Mrs. Copperbottom, I came all this way to tell you in person that your son Rodney, the man who got me off my big titanium tuchus, is now my right-hand bot and my eventual successor.
Eventual successor!
The sequel, Rodney's gonna kill Mr. Bigwell so that he can have the company for himself? Mm-hmm. Robots 2, Robots Revenge. I'd watch it!
Now I'm sure I've got a heart, because it's aching.
Good, well-timed Wizard of Oz reference right there. Mm-hmm. Okay, Margaret. I learned that success doesn't just happen like that. Sometimes you gotta work for it. Also, Robin Williams like definitely improved 80% of this film.
I learned that 2004 had some good movies.
Oh, for sure.
Some good movies. All right. Bye! See you next time!
I wish I could watch movies all the time.
Ha 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 ha! That would certainly be something.
Last on the agenda, Chris and Colin wanted to celebrate their favorite holiday, the time of the rodents. It's Groundhog Day. Let's get into it.
Groundhog Day!
It's Groundhog Week!
Groundhog Week! Woo! You may think of it as Bulldog Week. We call it Groundhog Week. Every week is Groundhog Week. Except this week is actually Groundhog Week.
That's the real Groundhog Week!
That's the real
baby.
Thing. It's Groundhog Day yesterday. We want to just celebrate this fantastic holiday.
You may have heard the news. Groundhog Hole is being filled up.
Everywhere, all around the country. People are disrespecting the groundhog.
He literally he can control the weather.
This guy is cool. Stop doing that.
We're digging more holes for him.
We're digging holes.
While Colin digs that hole, let me tell you some more groundhog facts. Groundhogs, they're not actually hogs, but they do live in the ground. Groundhog fact number two. You ever seen a groundhog? That's right, the answer is no. They don't exist, except for on Groundhog Day. And Groundhog Week, baby. Let's get back to digging.
Quick reminder, every week is Groundhog Week. Respect your groundhogs. get back to digging. Groundhog fact. Groundhogs drown in water. Let's get back to digging. Groundhog fact. Someone filled in a hole! Someone's filling it in! Right beneath our very noses.
Don't stand for it.
I hate you!
Now dig that hole back up.
Anyways, everyone, I hope you love groundhogs as much as I do. As much as my friend here, Colin, does. Because you know what? They're rare, they're beautiful, they're brown. What do you have to say about groundhogs?
Groundhogs, my heart beats for you.
I would throw myself upon the sea.
I would dig a hole for a groundhog. That's what I would do.
And you know what I would do? I would dig up the sea for a groundhog. I'll get all that water out of there.
Guess what? It's Groundhog Week, baby.
And guess what after that? I love you, baby. Never leave my side.
And guess what after that?
They had to come back.
That was an awesome groundhog segment.
Teachers and students, if you would like to have something filmed and shown here at Bulldog Weekly, let us know at the ORCTV station.
Be sure to check out our Vimeo channel for everything we film here at ORCTV. We film sports games, town meetings, school events, and so much more.
That concludes this week's episode of Bulldog Weekly. Until next time, I'm Chris.
And I'm Margaret.
And this is Bulldog Weekly.